How many different ways can a race with six runners be completed? Assume there is no tie. We can approach this two ways. We can approach this using the counting principle or using a permutation, and we'll discuss both. To use the counting principle, since there are six runners, we want to think of this as six different events, which we'll model using six horizontal bars. So the first event here would be the possible number of first place finishers, so we'll call this event E sub 1. The second event would be the possible number of second place finishers, which we'll call E sub 2, given someone already won first place. The next event would be E sub 3, the number of possible third place finishers, given first and second has already been decided, and so on. So we'd have E sub 4, E sub 5, and E sub 6. So now we'll determine the number of ways each of these events can occur. The product of these numbers of ways will give us the different ways these six runners can finish. So again, starting with first place, since there are six runners, there are six possible outcomes, or six possible winners. So we'd have six times. Now given someone already won first, how many possible second place finishers would there be? Well, there would be five, because one of them already won first. So times five times. Now for the third place finisher, there's only four possibilities, since two runners have already placed. So times four. You can see the pattern here. There are three possible winners of fourth place, two possible winners of fifth place, only one possible winner of sixth place, again given the other runners have already placed. So using the counting principle, this product will tell us how many different ways the six runners can complete the race. And 6 times 5 times 4 times 3 times 2 times 1, which is also 6 factorial, equals 720. Which means there are 720 different ways a race with six winners can be completed. Again, this is assuming there is no tie. The second way to solve this problem would be to use a permutation. Remember, when using a permutation, this means the order matters. And when considering how six runners can finish a race, of course the order does matter. And since we have six runners, and they will all finish, the number of ways they can finish would be 6 permute 6. So if we have 6 permute 6, notice n is 6 and r is also 6. So we would have n factorial, or 6 factorial, divided by n minus r factorial, which would be 6 minus 6 factorial, or 6 factorial divided by 0 factorial. And 0 factorial is just 1, so this is 6 factorial, which we saw above is 720. So whether we use the counting principle or the permutation, there are 720 ways to finish a race with six runners, given there is no tie. I hope you found this helpful.